Alain Boutelier. I'm here with Martin Hinton, the senior producer of Political Insiders, in place of two people. You're better than two people, Martin.
I'm playing shortstop and second base today.
Well, Pat and Doug couldn't be here today, but that's okay. We've got you. And the scandals that never go away have now returned to finally be front page. The IRS scandal and Benghazi. New developments in the last few days in both of them, and more certain to come. First, the IRS. The hearing on Friday was an explosive hearing with Mr. Koskinen, the head of the IRS, revealing 3 years after it happened that, amazingly, Lois Lerner's computer crashed.
Looked like he had a gallon of chamomile tea before he testified. He was so
I think he had, as someone said, an intermuscular injection of Thorazine before he went on
Botox in the face.
Oh, no one's ever said I don't tell the truth. I don't believe you, said all the congressmen. But who can believe that Lois Lerner's computer crashed and all her emails are gone, and then six other officials who were involved in this thing?
But not just that, it's exactly the emails that they're looking
for. And they don't tell the Congress till this week.
I don't, you know, I'm not an IT expert, I guess I've been an adult for a while now. And
maybe
it seems to
that's
me,
questionable.
Yes, most of the time in the last 20 plus years I've been an adult. Can you think of another scandal where the emails were suddenly unavailable?
No. No, and I think we need to bring Edward Snowden back from Russia to have him find them for us. That might be the deal we made.
Is the NSA, like, by the way,
They have them. These emails exist, and they don't want us to see them, which means they're bad. There is a cover-up. Now, hold off on that for a sec. That's okay. The IRS. More hearings to come.
This week there's more hearings.
Now, also last week, out of nowhere, the beginning of the week, big announcement comes, we have apprehended Mr. Katala, the first big arrest a year and a half, almost 2 years, after the Benghazi attack. And the cynic in me says that the Obama White House needed an agenda-changing story, that everything was going bad for them lately. So they said, we'll just go grab this guy, and we will run the news cycle for several days. We will run Benghazi. We will say what happened.
But I thought the film was the reason Benghazi happened.
On that note, the new book called...
It does seem the guy went to Starbucks a little too often. I mean, wasn't he interviewed by the Times in some cafe?
He was sitting on the porch of a luxury hotel having tea with various reporters, Elizabeth Palmer of CBS News, CNN. He's been around town denying his involvement.
Apparently hiding in plain sight has
been hiding. What do you think, though? You think it's possible the White House went and said, we need
the
a
phrase
story?
Wag the dog is, you know.
Wag the dog. They did that with Bergdahl, I think.
That's what the critic would say. Yeah. As I've said it here before in this very chair, I'm a cynical person, and I just can't believe that it isn't. It's so obviously politically convenient that it requires explanation. Why now?
Right.
And that explanation has not come from anyone credible, and it's been filled with a void of, well, because of what you've said, and nobody's come back and said, that's not true, here's the reason we did it now. We've seen reports from people who were in the special operations community saying we could have gotten this guy any time. Again, these are unnamed sources, so who knows.
Right.
But it does stink, and no one's explained why it shouldn't stink.
And we know that every administration pretty much runs itself the same way. On Monday morning, there is a meeting to set the agenda for the week and the next week and so forth. And they'll say, okay, this week's going to be Education Week. The president's going to go give a speech in a high school in Cincinnati, and he's going to issue a thing. I think they sat down and they said, we have to change the bad news cycle that we're undergoing on IRS, on the VA, on all these scandals. We need something we can control. Oh, let's go grab this guy. Mm-hmm. The House committee is gearing up, the select committee on Benghazi. Why not? We grab this guy now. We put him on a slow boat. Not to China, but to Washington.
The USS New York, of course,
ironically,
too, right?
Yeah, made with the steel from the World Trade Center. And they've got a special team on there interrogating him, and they're going to take their sweet time getting to the States. They're allowed to do this, apparently, legally, without reading him his Miranda rights. And then he'll get to Washington. Just when the committee is gearing up, they'll have pre-trial hearings and all. where the Justice Department can control the agenda of their story of what happened on Benghazi.
Do you think you get a perp walk of him in chains from the helicopter to a van and
maybe,
all that?
Maybe. But they'll be able to leak out stuff. They've interrogated the guy by then for several weeks.
Yeah.
They will have info they can leak out to make the administration look good.
All right.
That's the cynic in me.
Okay. Well, you've made a prediction. We'll see what happens.
All right. So we have the IRS is heating up. We have Benghazi never stopped heating up, at least here on Fox. The mainstream media, Martin, has finally started covering both these stories.
Well, you mentioned last night the IRS story was on the evening news.
Yep. Last Friday night. First time they had the hearing, and there are going to be these other hearings. And I think they can't deny it anymore. This is a big story.
I think that that one line from Ryan about the IRS.
I don't believe you.
Well, no. He made the substantive thing he said that really rung true with me was that he said, you expect everyone to keep 7 years of their financial records in case they're audited, and you're telling me that you guys can't, you're going to let a mistake like this, giving them all the benefit of the doubt you could, that could happen? That is a universal.
Right. Everybody's encountered the IRS.
Yeah, it is. You know, the fact that you can't do your taxes without paying a professional, I mean, if you're doing any kind of deductions or anything like that, it is complicated. And I think that if they can strike that sort of across the political spectrum, this is dangerous.
Right.
You know, all this power lies with one group, and then they can just throw stuff away and claim, we lost all that.
It's a government out of control. And I think that these two scandals, IRS and Benghazi, plus the other items, all help the Republicans for this November. I mean, everything is going badly for the chief Democrat, the president. That has to, on the margins at least, help Republicans win six or more seats.
Senate. I would think along the lines of what you guys have said in the past about the Benghazi thing is that they need to stay calm.
Above it.
The truth has no allies.
In both of them.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, we'll see if the Republicans can. All right, I'm John LeBoutelier with Martin Hinton. Don't forget to watch us on Sunday night, 7:30, with Harris Faulkner on Fox News Channel. Thank you.